Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Chromolume Theater at the Attic welcomes you to this evening's performance of the Michael John LaChuisa musical, Hello Again. At this time, we ask that you turn off your cell phones or any devices that may distract you. Please be advised that the audio or video recording and the taking of photographs of this evening's performance is strictly prohibited. In the unlikely event of an emergency, please take a moment to locate the exit into you, which may be directly in front of you through the stage or from where you came in. If you enjoyed our performance, please feel free to tweet, Facebook, email, and call all of your friends, family, and colleagues and tell them about our show. And don't forget to check in at Chromolume Theater, as well as visiting our website at www.crtheater.com for more information about us and what we have going on. Hello Again is performed without an intermission. And now, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Thank you. what's your name?
My name? Oh, Jesus.
Mine's Leocadia.
That's a good one.
Hey there, where you go? Let me see your face.
What for?
You don't have to remember a face, a place, or when. So how about a dime, love? It's for mine, your man. We may never. Hello again.
Go to hell.
Hey! You son of a bitch. Hey! Where's my brooch? You son of a bitch! You stole my brooch! Oh, hey! You!
I got a little time.
Christ almighty.
You could have had that redhead in there.
Yeah, so what?
She'd spend all your dough.
Yeah, I know.
Doctors and nurses here has prompted the Red Cross to issue a state of emergency here.
Nurse! Hi.
You want something?
No. Yes, it's hot in here.
You want the fan on?
Yes. No. Hot's okay. Never mind.
You want a painkiller?
Is Mother home?
No.
My father?
No.
Me?
Out.
Just you and I.
Just you and me.
So,
how's the ankle today?
Awful. I'll never play tennis again.
It's only a sprained ankle. Should have healed a week ago.
I told Mother I didn't need a nurse, but you know Mother. There's no arguing with her. She's just so big.
What's it you reading?
Stendhal.
What's it about?
Oh, it's fascinating. It's for my romance and world literature class. I just finished his notes on his visit to Florence, Italy.
Yeah.
He was visiting all these cathedrals, and at this one particular cathedral, there were these fresco paintings.
Yeah.
These frescoes so overwhelmed him that he thought he was dying.
Yeah.
God! But isn't that fascinating? What that must be like?
Reading poems.
Dying. I know what I need. I need water.
Okay.
Time.
My ankle feels better.
Great. Pass the water.
I'm thinking about getting my own place soon. Love is a terribly confusing ordeal.
Thank you. enjoy it. Stay focused. Her tongue is.
Her lips are.
I know there's trouble ahead.
Why can't I get it up and keep it up without all the work? Story of my life. Sorry little story of my life. I met her, the one I think I love.
Let's face the music instead.
I never worked so hard to keep it hard, and then I met her, and then I lost interest.
It's her fault.
It's my fault to think that stealing someone's lonely little life would be the greatest of adventures in the sorry little story of my life.
Dinner. I'll go first.
love you. Now it won't go down.
I'm morally bankrupt.
Sometimes I like to forget that I do.
Sometimes I like to forget.
The greatest of adventures is remembering how much I love you.
What?
If I loved you every second, every minute, every day, we'd be bored.
Bored.
Forgetting now and then keeps a marriage full of life. Forgetting helps to keep the romance new. It's like a second honeymoon. Every time that I recall the angel that I found back then in you. I've had at least 1,000 honeymoons since our wedding night.
Marianne is having an affair.
What?
Her lover is a college boy.
Well, I don't think you should associate with this, Marianne.
Of course.
It reflects upon your character and mine. I have a business, remember?
Uh-huh.
Your friend will have to pay for her sordid little need for
pleasure.
Carnal gratification. I don't think you understand what that type of woman is up to. That type of woman is morally bankrupt. No better than a prostitute.
Do you? Or before we were married, did you?
Did I what?
We've been married.
5 years and I still don't know your past. Did you ever know that kind of woman?
Yes. Yes, and it is a sad part of my life. And I would imagine that that young woman is dead now. That type of girl dies young.
Why did you do it?
Gratification.
Ah, yes. Carnal gratification.
Angel, if I had not found you, God knows where I would be right now.
God knows.
The greatest of adventures which a man and woman share is marriage. Repeat.
The greatest of adventures that a man and woman share is marriage.
Good. Cheating on one's husband isn't wise. Marriage cannot tolerate lies. The greatest of adventures we have chosen, my love. There's no turning back. Emily, please don't forget.
I won't.
There's no turning.
Thank you. woman share is marriage.
It's your eyes. They remind me of my long-lost father.
You said you never knew your father.
I got pictures.
When I saw you born at Southampton, I thought, there you were, all alone, sailing across the sea,
sweltering in steerage,
looking lost and hungry,
fatherless,
fatherless,
penniless,
innocent, reminding me of me.
And you came all the way down to third class to find me.
I thought that I've been looking for someone.
Ain't we all? What's that tune? I gotta use the clock.
I beg your pardon, sir.
Yes, I asked not to be disturbed.
Yes, the captain has requested that all passengers don their life jackets and report to the lifeboat station, sir.
What has happened?
Seems to be struck a bit of ice, sir.
Is it serious?
Women and children are being lowered, sir.
Look at the ridiculous, this ship came. We're sinking.
Rather quickly, sir.
What should I do?
I hurry topside, sir.
Is the boat feel tilty or like that?
We only have a little time. We have to spend it wisely. I want to spend my time with you,
sir.
Listen to the music. Everything is fine. Let's have some bawdy. Is that your glass or mine?
Mine.
While you're young, you mustn't squander a splendid night such as this. Listen to the music. And give an old man.
What's the rush? Let's not go overboard. Don't forget, you're a gentleman, and I'm a Catholic. Take it slow, you've had a lot of wine. I swear the boat is tilting, and it's
have a chocolate. Listen to the music. Music doesn't lie. It says I found an angel, and now I'd like to fly.
No, I won't get into the boat without my husband.
Can't you hear the cello sigh? In every note lies the truth. Listen to this whole will pass, this ship will
Jackie, my newfound muse.
futon, candles, incense, reefer, and Jackie the Angel says.
He made it sound bigger. Where does he sleep?
Who?
Paul Newman, you said he stays here when he visits New York.
Oh, Paul's an artist. He loves sleeping on the couch. Silence, Bergman, tight shirt.
I'm stoned.
What do you do, Jackie?
Temp.
Close up, me. What is it that you really want to do?
Temp?
God, I wish I could get inside that little head and see the world as you see it, experience what you experience, but oh, I'd probably ruin things, wouldn't I?
You talk a lot.
Tell me what you desire most. No, don't, let me guess. No, tell me. Have you found your ideal lover?
What's with all the questions?
I want to know every single beautiful thing about you.
I survived a shipwreck. That was Sunday night. I survived a plane crash. That was Monday night. Tuesday dropped some acid. Thursday went to sleep. Dreamed that I was floating, floating, floating in Richard Nixon's pool.
Jackie the Angel says,
one I love kisses me, and I'm safe. The one I love touches me, and I flow. The one I love is here, holding me. I now
take this again. The One I Love, directed by me, written by me, starring me and she. Take 12. The playwright attempts to seduce his leading lady during a romantic weekend tryst at the spa.
Spa, Angel.
How nice.
near my toilet.
I must entice her to do my new play. You are the vessel into which I pour my soul. Let us consummate our love, artist
and muse.
Come and tell me the plot of your new play.
I have written you the role of a lifetime, an innocent, helpless waif.
But I must be an essential creature, a modern woman. I cannot play a lie.
You shall play the part I wrote for you.
Company, and
a good movie once a week, starring you. I like to know when I'm enjoying myself, whenever I'm enjoying myself.
Enjoy!
We may die tomorrow.
Cancelled!
Yeah, what would have been is sad. Later on is...
sad.
Sad.
My congressman is a philosopher.
Your congressman should say goodnight.
Stop this, you're teasing me! I haven't seen you all week.
I will see you tomorrow night for dinner.
You know, a lot of other men would be more than happy to be right here, right now, alone with me.
Sally, I am happy.
You said happiness was a lie. Did I say something to scare you?
Sally, this arrangement we have.
It's real.
We shouldn't pretend.
Stop.
The truth is...
oh,
say goodnight.
I can play the mistress of the congressman. Hire me to work on your image. I'll manipulate the press. We'll buy a registered house with a Georgetown address. We'll write a place off as a work expense and screw the IRS. I'll play advisor to the congressman. That's a role it takes a lot of soul to do.
Thank you.
Here, I want to give you a present.
What is it?
Diamonds from an admirer.
Oh, Sally.
You know what do you say?
Thank you.
No. What do you say?
I have to go.
Go. Go, yes, of course, you have to go. My director will kill me if I oversleep, so.
I will call you next week when I'm back in New York.
Next week?
The fundraiser.
What about tomorrow night?
Sally, I can't.
8 o'clock would be perfect.
No, it wouldn't be. For the soul, I mean, it wouldn't be.
We're not talking about souls here. We're talking about dinner. Have your secretary make reservations at Café des Artistes.
It's right next door to my studio.
Sweet dreams, my congressman! Philosopher.
What I hope to find in all my lovers.
in a new lover's was there. Here, shallow breath, sleep and death, all in not my own. Someone dreamed with me. Someone dreamed beside me in the dark. Sleep, angel, don't wake up. I am in your dream. Sleep, lover, don't wake up. Don't wake up, or I'll wake up alone. Girlfriend I knew, my wife and my ex. Shake hands or something.
Sure.
I have no idea how I got here.
I usually work the river. Sometimes, if I find a guy I like, I bring him back here. All of Marianne's girls work here. Listen, you can hear Emily snoring next door.
And I suppose I should pay you.
Who mentioned money? Who mentioned pay?
You don't want anything from me?
No, handsome. I don't need nothing.
You're happy, man. That's nice. Were we lovers?
Don't you remember, handsome?
Leocadia. If only I had kissed you.